A very good evening to all of you present here. We, the members of Team Samarthya, cordially welcome you to our first ever online orientation session. Today, you'll be acquainted with the journey we all have in Banasthali while pursuing a life that helps us achieve our dreams. You'll get to know about the campus, how it feels like to be there, what all amazing things do we have out there, followed by exploring all the different branches of Bachelor's of Technology, and finally, coming to the most exciting part of the session, Team Samarthya. We'll have a placement discussion later in the session and hear the experience of our alumni, which would inspire each and every one of you to reach all the milestones in this world. So, keep all of your work aside and get ready for an enriching and insightful hour with Team Samarthya. Don't forget to jot down your queries as we'll be answering all of them in the last 5 minutes. So, let's get started.
I am Aditi Trivedi, core member of Team Samarthya. I am pursuing BTech in Electronics and Communication from Banasthali Vidyapeeth. As we all know that most of you haven't seen Banasthali Vidyapeeth yet. So let's take a virtual tour of Banasthali.
Let's start from the very beginning. When you enter from the gate of Banasthali, then there you will see a board on which it is written that Aam Rasta Nahi Hai. Don't take this sign negatively, as this is true that not everyone can survive here. But as we know, ki sone ko aag mein jitna zyada tapaya jata hai, wo utna hi zyada chamakta hai. We have our college bus as well, through which we can go one place to other place in our campus. Moving forward, the most exciting thing about Banasthali Vidyapeeth is its five-fold education. Here you can learn horse riding, aviation, dance, singing, fine arts, shooting, and many more. You can also learn foreign languages here. There are also banks and post office in our campus. There's a hospital too named Arogya Mandir in the campus. We have markets near our hostels. First market that is at the end of the campus is named as Old Market, and the other one is New Market. There are many canteens as well named Mukteshwari, Spicy Bites, Shanu's and Annapurna, where you can go with your friends whenever you want and enjoy the food. Hostel gate get closed at around 8 to 9 p.m. and after that we have to stay inside the hostel only. But I can assure you all that you all gonna love your hostel and hostel life. Hostels of BTech are extremely beautiful. Dress code of Banasthali promotes Indian culture, as we have to wear kurtis of khadi only. You can wear anything inside the hostel, but if you are going outside, then it is necessary to wear khadi. The speciality of our college is that we celebrate each and every festival, either it is Holi, Diwali, Lohri or any other festival. We celebrate many departmental fests, but the most exciting and amazing fest of Banasthali Vidyapeeth is Apaji Fest, or you can say Apaji Mela. This fest is celebrated each and every year in the memory of our founder's birthday. The student and teacher wait for this fest whole year, and after the celebration, We left with beaming faces and pride that we are a part of an institution which is a jewel in the crown among the women's universities, not only in India, but across the globe.
Okay, so now you all surely got that you will never get bored in Banasli, as we all have a lot of things to do there. After watching this video, I hope you got the idea of Banasli Vidyapeeth, about the life of Banasli. So now my co-teammate would be presenting introduction of BTech in Banasli.
BTech in Banasthili comprises of 8 branches. We have 3 departments dedicated for these courses. AVNET is dedicated for CS and IT. Urja Mandir is dedicated for electronics. And SOA is dedicated for EE, EI and MT. If we talk about the curriculum, then in the first 2 years, you only need to stay consistent with your regular studies, and also you have plenty of time to explore your talent and groom your personality. In second year, you're also asked to prepare a seminar on any topic of your choice. In third year, you have to work on a minor project in a group of 2 to 4 people. It is compulsory to do 6 months internship in your fourth year. And the college provides you with options in both private and government sectors like DRDO, ISRO. There is a decent record for placement. There are also certain prospects like some technical courses exclusively for BTech students like Android app development, web development, networking, .NET, which adds extra edge to your knowledge and increases your proficiency. The ESOL of Banasthili provides you an opportunity for attending Women Entrepreneurship Development Program and many more, especially to students who are from technical background. This knowledge provides you to communicate more effectively with the tech and the project team.
Mayuk is the national level technical fest. Mayuk is a forum for akin minds to interact. It provides students a rich scholastic platform through teach-back sessions, workshops, guest lectures, group discussions, technical, non-technical rounds, and online submission event. It's a place where technical skills, creativity, personality, imagination, all combined with a pinch of fun.
Hey guys, my name is Arjuna and I'm in the third year of mechatronics French. Let me start by asking a really simple question. What are the branches you are in right now? One of the 2 preferences that you filled in the admission form. If yes, congratulations, but if your answer is no, then be sad, because 95% of you would be saying no. Now, what is the reason? The reason behind this is that from the childhood, we are made to believe that engineering is all about software engineering and mechanical engineering. But the truth is, each and every branch is important and have the equal scope. Let us talk about my branch, mechatronics. The thing about mechatronics is that you won't find this branch in every other college in India. Only a few IITs and some private institutions provide courses in this branch. You know, earlier when people used to ask me, what is this branch? Like, what is mechatronics? I would simply say, it is mechanical and electronics, mechatronics. But the truth is, it is more than that. This branch has a part of every single branch in it, and you guys already know the future is automation and robotics, so there is a lot of scope in this branch. Now let us talk about another branch, electrical and instrumentation engineering, or EI. So this branch is basically study of various instruments and their control. It also includes designing of sensors, integrated circuits and electronic chips. Like, how cool is that? Now, the thing about EI and I cannot focus more on this, but every industry needs an EI engineer. And everything right now is getting automated, so this branch actually has a large scope. And a very few of you might know this, but EI is the base of mechatronics and robotics engineering. So you can guess how important this branch is.
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, Nandini, you are audible.
Kindly pause the video, please. Okay. Good evening, guys. This is Nandini Gupta, third year undergrad in Electrical and Electronics and co-team member of Samartha. I'll be introducing you to two of the ancient and core engineering branches of EE and EC. If you have ever been, or if you have ever came across the MIT course bulletin, you might be familiar with the fact that all the engineering branches are divided into two fundamental categories that are electrical and non-electrical. Electrical branches, or the Department of Electrical Engineering, primarily includes electronics and communications, electrical and electronics, computer science, instrumentation, and robotics. And the non-electrical ones include civil, mechanical, biological, chemical, and nuclear sciences. So to put it in simpler terms, electrical engineering is the mother of all ever-evolving and high-paying engineering roles in the tech world today. Now, let me introduce you to my own branch, electrical and electronics. Electrical engineering is one of the ancient branches of engineering. And there were three branches, civil, mechanical, and electrical, when the engineering stream started. This discipline is mainly grounded in mathematics and science, and it finds its applications in solving a wide variety of engineering problems in the world today. You can go from building chips, and you can also build spot docks like the ones from Boston Dynamics, to solving transmission line and power distribution problems using simulation and coding. The electrical engineering branch does not include only this field, but also computer science. You might know about the Department of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science in MIT, which I cannot focus enough because this branch is the mother branch of engineering. Now, next, I would like to jump to the branch electrical and electronics and communications. Electronics and communications is again one of the oldest branches in the field of engineering. Approximately 50, more than 60 years old, this branch has attracted students with its larger than life applications from almost all over the world. This engineering field, whether it be a computer chip or a simple calculator, electronics and communications are the two most happening in today's technology. Also, the main thing, it provides the flexibility of choosing software field over the hardware field, which of course is not provided by any other core branches. Job opportunities are again endless. Endless job opportunities are present in electronics and communications. You can work as a server designer in Google, launch a satellite with NASA or ISRO. You can also design the next generation super processor with Intel, or you can launch your own startup to supply the Indian Army with drones or other efficient combat tools. With that being said, you're in for a great, great ride choosing Bachelors of Technologies these two fields. Now, I would request my teammate Upasana to take over. Thank you so much.
Good evening, everyone present over here. Today, I am delighted to bring to you all the main motto of today's meeting, which is nothing but the birth of Samarthya. I am Upasana Nonia, BTech third year student, majoring in electronics and communication, guys. As we know, A birth is a very beautiful yet a very difficult thing in anyone's life. So, as Team Samarthya took its birth, it was not an easy task. A few bunch of very young and enthusiastic minds were put together in order to bring to our branches, which is EC, EI, EE and MCTR, to limelight. And that is how our Samarthya came into limelight, guys. You know, the initial days were literally a huge struggle, you know, just in order to convince our HOD, bring everything to notice, explain our thoughts, everything. It was not so easy, guys. But yes, our seniors never gave up and they finally came up with a very good team, which is Team Samarthya. And we all the members of Team Samarthya literally feel delighted and proud to be its part, guys. Because it is not only a team, but we call it SamFam. And it is indeed a family to us. We have all grown here through various stages. And similarly, along with our growth, this team flourished and grew too. It gained attention. It gained achievement. Everything. And today, I am literally feeling so delighted. You know, just because this might be our very first interaction with you juniors. And we are here introducing over 30 plus members of proud Team Samarthya to all of you guys. And this is our proud team base you can see on the screen. I would tell you guys that what is the importance of being the part of a team, guys? Because being a part of any team not only develops your personality, but it also enhances your holistic growth, girls. Because, you know, I understand some of you might be very concerned about your marks and everything. But trust me, girls, only academics is not going to take us anywhere. Being a part of college and being a part of any of the clubs, not only Samarthya I'm talking about, be it any club, if you are a part of such a committee, if you're a part of such a team, then you know you can grow. You can understand how team management takes place, how you can develop your personality, and also how can you put forward your word. You will be able to understand teamwork. You will be able to understand how you can actually put yourself forward. I'm definitely sure many of you might be introverts over here. Not everybody has the confidence, girls, to talk in front of a crowd. I was one of you guys. Yes, I was one of you. And today, I am literally very confident and definitely I give the whole credit to my Team Samarthya. It has made me what I am today. And thus, I am taking a live session with you girls today. And I am literally very delighted that I took the initiative. You know, I came out of my nutshell. I came out of my comfort zone. You know, giving interview and giving exams, the prelims, the whole recruitment process was not easy. I was literally numb. I was not able to understand how to do it. Like when the PI took place, the personal interview took place, I was literally feeling, okay, this is the end. I messed up. I'm not going to be a part of it. But when I was selected, and from my very first year, I have been the part of Team Samarthya. It is my third year and I am the core team member. And trust me, I have literally seen my graph going up and up every day, girls. So yes, it is very important. Obviously, not everyone can be a part of the team, but why not try for it? If not this time, maybe in the other time, you would be selected, right? So at least by trying, by applying to be the part of any of the teams, you will understand where you actually stand, where you actually need to work. Because girls, just studying won't help us in our main recruitment for companies, you know, for job placements. Being a part of a team, you know, coming out of the comfort zone, it will actually be able to, you know, build up that presenting skills when somebody would be taking your interview, when you would be actually sitting for a job. At that time, only academics is not going to work, girls, to be very honest. So yes, this was all about the short introduction to you all. And now I would like to pass on the mic to my core team member, which is also my classmate, Vibha Rajpal. Thank you, girls.
its climax, we have our annual technical fest Pinnacle, which is the showstopper. It is held every October and contains a series of events that run simultaneously for 3 consecutive days. We have a main event, Utkranti, on the first day, in which the students use their innovation and creativity by applying their knowledge to create working models. Many events ranging from technical to fun domain follow up the queue. We also bring to you a series of submission events, and the winners of all the events are honored and rewarded with trophies and certificates in our final stage event by the esteemed judges. Talking about the last year, we had events like Utkranti, the working model making competition, Cornock, which was a fun event, Climatic Coalition, which was an MUN based event to spread awareness on how to apply science in improving the condition of present day Earth. We had this event as we are the only electronics club of Banasthali Vidyapeeth, and we feel that it is our responsibility to apply our knowledge and skills to create technology without compromising or ignoring the place where we live in. We had many other events like Quizzards, which was, as the name suggests, a quiz-based event. We had the Battle of the Bots, in which students made their own robots and made them race, and the fastest one to reach the end point won. Then we had many exciting submission events like Techno Memer, where students used their knowledge and humor to create funny, relatable memes related to engineering and science. We had Time Turner, Avenge the Fallen, and Perspectography, which was a photography event. These 3 days are much awaited by the students as they get a good change from their usual routine and enjoy the gala time with their friends.
Now, let's just talk about the team structure. So we follow a hierarchy in our club. We have third years and the fourth years as our core team members, and the first years and the second years as our sub-core team members. Now, why this hierarchy? See, this hierarchy has been made to give students a corporate feel while being in their college, and also for the smooth functioning of our club. Just don't worry, we all work together as a team and we don't have any separate departments or designations pre-decided. We work according to the required task. I hope you guys would be aware of the concept of a leader without any title. We simply follow that, and it implies that every team member is a leader in itself. Every fresh idea in the room is welcomed, no matter where it is coming from. So here, we are open for the recruitment of our new team members. You all might be wondering, what are the fundamental qualities that we need to become the team member of Team Samarth? So the fundamental qualities that we are looking for are being self-driven, curious, and open to learning. And we think anyone could learn any technical skill, but these 3 qualities are the very basic ones that we need.
Hello everybody, this is Neha Vardhan, 2020 graduate in the branch Electronics and Instrumentation, and currently working with Aditya Builder Group as a graduate engineer. Talking about my college life, I must say I had a different mindset before coming to college. Like going out on a trip, hanging out with friends on weekends, having irregular schedule, bugging the classes, attending several events, having musical concerts and all of that. But when I came to Banasthali, it was altogether a different picture in front of me. Like 9-to-5 classes, assessment, assignments, periodicals, semesters, labs, and all of that. Then one day I thought, no, this is not something I wanted my college to be. Like, for just sake of learning something new, just for the sake of adding some values other than my academics, I joined Samarth here. And trust me guys, when I say my college days were the best days of my life, then a big credit goes to Samarth family. It was not just because I was able to be a part of a team, I was able to conduct several events altogether, but apart from these things, I got a chance to put my ideas in front of people. I got a chance to implement those ideas on a broader scale. I learned how to work in a team. I learned leadership skills. And these are something which you can't learn while sitting in a class and reading books. So I, at the end of the BTEC, I realized that these qualities made me different from other people. You know, while you're facing an interview, in your placement, these things really matters. The people who is taking your interview, the interviewer has a different mindset of yours. They see you from different perspective. And I experienced this thing while I was giving interviews for my placement at the end of my college life. And it helped me a lot. So this time the situation is pretty different. You all will be connected virtually. You will be conducting several events virtually. So it will be altogether a new experience for you guys and for us as well. So I'm looking forward to see how you're gonna perform this year. And just for that, all the very best. I have full faith on you guys that you will rock it. And for the newcomers, I just wish you all the best. Grab this opportunity and be a part of Samarth here. So all the best guys. Bye-bye.
Hello everyone. As you already know, my name is Harshita and I have been a part of Samarth since my first year. And I would be lying if I said that Samarth wasn't the best decision I made in my college life. I actually come from a very small town. So as a freshman, everything seems confusing. Just like you guys, I was attending my orientation of Samarth in 2018 and I was so fascinated from everything my seniors were. I gave the written test, but when I got selected, I was so happy. Like, I cannot explain how happy and excited I was. But at the same time, I was scared. I was fighting to speak in front of people. But then I was like, who cares? I'm gonna do this. And then I gave the group discussion, the personal interview. And when the results came, I was the only one from my branch who got selected. And when I first joined Samarth, there were so many things I literally had no idea about. But my seniors, my super seniors, they were always by my side and they guided me all the way along. Now, this team actually helped me to enhance my communication management as well as technical skills. So not only we conduct tests and events, we actually share a lot of unforgettable memories, meetups and farewells. Also, we had a lot of events. So we call this team Sam Fam. It's because we consider ourselves to be a family. We are a team not because we work together, no. We are a team because we respect, trust and care for each other. So I'm just gonna wrap this up by saying my life motto. Take that chance, grab that opportunity. Because in the end, you're gonna regret the chances you didn't take. Thank you.
Hey guys, my name is Nandita Asthana. I'm the core member of Team Samarth. I'm pursuing BTEC in Electronics and Communication. So I was asked to share my experience, and if I have to sum it up in a word, it's a wholesome journey till now. Banasthal is a place where each and every girl is so talented, each and every girl is, you know, filled with enthusiasm and they're so motivated that you need to find your spot. You need to stand out from the crowd. And for me, clubs were the opportunity that I got, and I always had in mind that clubs are so cool because you get your own hoodie with the name at your back, you get your own iCards, people recognize you, teachers know your name, juniors know your name, so it's very cool. So I gave my prelims in my first year. I was selected in the GD round and I knew I messed up my interview, but I never gave up. I gave the prelims again in my second year, and here I am, I was selected. I still remember our first conversation with the seniors was on 3rd of August because it was my birthday. I remember the date, and from that day till now, I never felt unproductive. Everything that we were doing, whether it be small, like from writing emails, making posters, making PPTs, or talking to juniors, having interaction with teachers, everything was adding up to my personality, and it was such a learning experience that helped me to grow as a person. Apart from this, the best part of being in a club was that I was surrounded by such talented people, whether it be my juniors, co-team mates, or seniors. Every person's ideas were so unique. Every day for me was such a learning experience. Today, if I'm standing in front of you guys and speaking so confidently, it's just because of Team Samarth. It gave me that push and support that helped me to carve out myself into a confident and responsible girl. Before signing off, all I wanted to tell my juniors that do not miss this opportunity. Trust me, it's a life-changing experience. After 3 to 4 years, when you look back, you will realize that you made the right decision. So yeah, see you guys in the prelims. Till then, all the best. Take care and be safe. Bye.
Okay, girls, this was the end of the video that we prepared for you all, basically the orientation video. And we are literally very delighted to notify you all that we would be starting with our hiring process, that means recruitment for the batch 2021 very soon, girls. So yes, be active with us and we will be notifying you all very soon about when and how is the recruitment process going to take. So yes, stay tuned for that. Also, girls, now the stage is open for everyone. And I would like to tell you all that whoever have any doubts, any queries, want to say something about how you felt about the orientation, like any kind of a feedback or two words if you would like to share with us, we would be literally very happy to address you all. So kindly come forward and unmute yourself, girls, if you want to do so. Thank you. Thank you so much for the feedback, girls. Yeah, Pragya, what is your doubt? Please tell me.
Yeah, hello, Pasha. My
Hi,
doubt
Pragya.
Is that, is there any chance of branch change?
Okay, branch change as in what branch have you taken right now?
I have taken electronics and electrical and electronics.
Okay, and you want to switch it?
Yeah, like just one branch above to electrical and communication.
Okay, so basically I would like to be very honest with you, Pragya, that as such there is no switching, but you know, sometimes if you contact the office, then sometimes they might tell you that if you bring extraordinary scores, if you score really very well, and if you, you know, get to get a scholarship or something like that, sometimes they say so. If you, you know, contact any of the branch, like any of the branch from college, I'm saying, any of the offices, then they might tell you like this. But to be honest, as such, among all these 3 years, I have been the part of Banasthili. I have not seen any branch change practically happening. So I guess it is not very feasible on a practical level. And yeah, that's it.
Thank you.
Most welcome, Pragya. And I am literally very overwhelmed to see all those compliments flooding in the chat section, girls. Thank you so much. Thank you on behalf of whole team Samarthya. Yes, yes, Muskan, what is your doubt?
Upasana.
Yes, Nandini, tell me.
Sorry to interrupt, but kindly,
no, it's okay.
Kindly take up Tanisha Gupta's doubt first.
Cool. All right. Yes, Tanisha, can we have you speaking, please? Then after that, Muskan, please come forward. All right?
She has mentioned the query in the comment section.
Okay, actually, I'm not able to read the chat section right now. Okay. Nandini, if you have read it, would you like to please go forward with it?
So the question is, can you tell me that if I have an existing portfolio, then would I be choosed on the basis of it or I need to fill the form and all? Okay, so our recruitment process basically includes three steps. The first one is the application form. The second one would be judging on the basis of some skills. We'll be judging you live on any of the platforms. And the third will be personal interview. So yes, you will need to fill a form. You'll need to mention all your skills and you'll need to mention all your interests and proof of it. Anything you have made related to your interest, like say, if you want to join the technical team, do you have any projects related to that? Any simple project would also work. Maybe you have made a telescope in your 12th project. That simple telescope would also work. Maybe you've made a nice big IC containing circuit or anything like that. That would also work. Maybe if you're interested in design, we would like to see you doing some design work live. We would also appreciate if you have a design portfolio on Dribbble, something like that. We don't want to scare you away, but yes, we have high standards. So of course, we would never compromise with that. You'll need to have an excellent portfolio before you apply for the same.
Thank you so much for taking up that doubt, Nandini. Thank you so much. So yes, can I have Muskan unmuting herself, please? As she said, she had a doubt, right? Yeah. Hi, Muskan. Hi.
I'm in second year and I'm starting the project in the third year. So my doubt was, is it compulsory to have the team members of the same branch or we can have the team members of the other branches?
Okay, you're talking about the project that you're going to make in third year?
Yeah.
Okay, as far as we have seen it in our level right now, that we are supposed to make a team among our classmates only. I don't know how it was for our seniors because, you know, that time the scenario was different. At that time, people could actually work offline. They were working face to face, right? But as because we have switched to this online mode and we literally have no clue about how long the online mode is going to continue. So yes, as of now, we have been restricted to form groups only in our class. Yes, Muskan.
Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, Muskan. Anyone else?
Yeah, I had a doubt.
Yes, Mallika, tell me.
Just now, Nandini told that we have to prepare our portfolios according to our interest areas. So what are different fields? Are there any segregations within this group? Like technical and design and all that?
Okay, basically, I would like to tell you, Mallika, that because we are a technical team, so obviously the basic preference, or I can say the mother preference, is at least a bit of technical knowledge. We are not telling that you guys should be pro at technical field because we were also not pros when we were selected in phase one, like in our first year. Like, obviously, we were totally clueless. It was like, okay.
Yeah.
Very natural it is. So yes, we are not telling that you should be some very great achiever in the field, but definitely there are segregates. Like, you are very good in art and craft, so you can send us some examples of your work, your actual original work. I am I'm making myself very clear. If you are good in photography, so you can also attach the thing, but again, nevertheless, it should be always kept in mind that at least you should be a little bit of technically sound. So yes, I hope I have satisfied you, Mallika, with the answer. If not,
I mean, it has a typical collection in some sort of way. Doesn't that?
Mallika, can you please come again, because your voice couldn't reach me properly.
I was telling that anything that has a technical background or a technical touch will do.
Yeah, exactly. Think it in this way. Okay, you are from which branch, may I know?
Electronics and instrumentation.
Okay. You are from electronics and instrumentation. So yeah. You are in your first year or second year?
First year.
That's great. You are a fresher. So welcome to Banasthali, first of all, Mallika. So yes. So I would not expect from you that you would be knowing everything about your branch. Definitely not, because you have just started, right? Yeah. But at least whatever you have learned in your 10th, in your 11th, 12th, at least you must be having knowledge about this, right? Because you didn't come up straight away, like you passed the exams and everything. So, you know, it is as simple as that. Suppose you are good in art and craft, okay? You are presenting us your work. But when interview comes, when any other further levels come, we would not only be asking you about your art and craft. Getting my point? Mallika, am I audible to you? Okay, I am asking overall. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for it. I guess Mallika is having, she is having network issues. No worries. Any other doubts, girls?
Good evening, Dee.
Good evening, Sameksha. Good evening. Tell me.
Dee, thank you so much for giving this experience to all of us.
My pleasure. My pleasure. Tell me.
Dee, can you tell me something about how to improve our skills? Like someone was interested in different types of fields. So how to manage our classes and different types of activities in Banasthali life?
Okay. So you are in second year or first year?
No, I am in a first year in branch of electrical and electronics.
Okay, welcome to you too. Welcome to Banasthali.
Thank you so much.
And Sameksha, before I answer your exact question, I would like to ask you, what is your hobby?
See, my hobby is outdoor games like badminton, my favorite game. And I have to improve my drawing, like to making different types of structures and also, photography is also my hobby.
Okay, that's actually extraordinary, Sameksha, because you have enrolled yourself in a very excellent university which provides fivefold education, like my friend Aditi introduced in the very beginning of the session, right? So, you know, here are various activities in which you can enroll yourself. Like you said, you want to improve your drawing skills, right? That means you are somewhere or the interested in that field, right? So, you know, you can enroll yourself in creative arts, okay? And when you enroll yourself in creative arts, over there, they will beautifully make you learn step by step how you can improve your drawing skills. So, yes, you can do that. And apart from enrolling yourselves in activities, and you know, if you apply for our team recruitment or any other team, anything it be, first of all, Sameksha, I would like to tell you that do prioritize your work, okay? Because making a timetable somewhere or the other leaves us procrastinating things, to be very honest, because you know. Okay, I'll tell about myself. When I was in first year, I was in a dance team too. I was in a team Samarthya too. I was in parade too. That means in BSD, I was the commander. So there was a lot of things. And there was a time where I was not able to handle everything. I was feeling too much pressurized. But then I thought that I'm going to make a timetable. But you know, making a timetable just made things more worse. I was not,
able, not able to follow the timetable. Yeah, because
Exactly. Because you know, making a timetable only makes us procrastinate things, and it is not going to take us anywhere. So I would just, being a senior and being a part of all these chaos, I would like to say that you need to first prioritize your things, like what should be the priority, how the hierarchy should follow, like what are the things that you are going to do, and among your 24 hours, what is the priority level? If you follow this, I am definitely very sure everything would go smooth. So yes, that was my answer, Samiksha.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you, Samiksha. Thank you. Anyone else? Okay, are we having any?
Join now over the network connection. So I understood your point. Thanks for answering my query.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Malika. Thank you so much. Okay, do we have any questions in the chat section? Let me just scroll down quickly. Or I would request my team members that if they have spotted any question, then they can just tell me that. Okay, as far as I see, there are no doubts. So girls, are you having any doubts?
Hello.
Yeah. Hi, Aditi.
Hello, myself Aditi, and I'm in second year of electronics and communication. So I have a doubt that do we need to have a project in electronics itself, or it can be in web development field or Android development field also?
Okay, as I said again, Aditi, mostly it is preferred that we work on a working model, because that is our, you know, that is the thing we are majoring in, right, in our graduation. So it is preferable that we work on a working model, we prepare a project on our working model. But then nevertheless, again, we didn't get that opportunity this time, because you know, we all are at different places, and we don't know exactly when this lockdown is going to end, or exactly when we are going to, you know, go back to our college. So yes, all I would like to say is it is preferable that you make a working model. But again, nevertheless, if you coordinate well with the mentors assigned to you, yes, there would be mentors, which is there would be teachers whom you will be appointed as a mentor, and they will be guiding you throughout your project work. So you know, you can discuss the things with them, and if your idea is very great, if it is sound enough, then obviously it is accepted. Just you need to present your idea to the mentor very well, so that he is able to understand your idea, and he'll follow with that thing. So yes, you can, whenever the chance comes, you have to discuss it with your mentor, and then you can work accordingly. That's all, Aditi.
Thank you.
Okay. Anything else?
Okay, girls, even virtually, it was great interacting with all of you. Hope to see you applying for our team selection. Till then, take care and stay safe.